Hey guys, so today I'm going to be showing you how to make some really easy crochet scrunchies. And I've tried like a couple of methods how to crochet these scrunchies, and this is the method that I like the most, and it's the easiest to me. And also, this is my first crocheting video, so if you want to see more crocheting videos, just let me know in the comments down below. But yeah, I actually just learned how to crochet last year, around January actually. So January must be the crocheting month for me because I recently just started crocheting again, and I learned how to make these cute scrunchies. So this is what they look like. So yeah, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you enjoy this. And if you want to learn how to make these cute little scrunchies, then just keep watching. So the things that you will need are some scissors, a hair tie, some velvet yarn. I'm using the color blush. And you will also need a crochet hook. I'm using a size F, which is equal to a size 5 crochet hook. So to start, we're going to make a slip knot. And this is the way that I learned how to make a slip knot. You're just going to create a loop and then take the rest of your yarn and place it underneath the loop, and then just stick your hook in and under, and then you just take your yarn and pull it. But for now, we're just gonna set that aside. So next, you just wanna take your hair tie and stick your hook in, and then you can place your slip knot back on your hook and pull it through. So this is how I normally hold my yarn in my hand. So the first step we are going to do is you're just going to chain 2. So to do that, you're just going to pick up a piece of yarn on your hook and pull it through. And you want to make sure that you just do that 2 times to create a chain of 2. And then for the rest, we're just going to be doing a double crochet around the whole hair tie. So to double crochet, you're just going to pick up a piece of yarn on your hook and then go under your hair tie and then pull another piece of yarn through. So now you should have 3 loops on your hook, and then pick up another piece of yarn and only pull through 2 of the loops. So now you should have 2 more loops on your hook, and then pick up another piece of yarn and then just pull that through the last 2 loops on your hook. And then that will count as 1 double crochet. And I just did the same thing around my whole hair tie, and I did about 45 to 50 double crochet around my whole hair tie. It doesn't have to be exactly that, as long as it covers your whole rubber band. And if you want a more of a ruffle look to your scrunchie, you could always push it tighter together and keep adding more. But for my scrunchie, I did about 45 double crochets. So I will just walk you through one more time. You're just going to pick up a piece of yarn, go under the hair tie, pull another piece of yarn through, and then pick up another piece of yarn, pull it through the first 2 loops, and then pick up another piece of yarn and then pull it through the last 2 loops. And that is how you do double crochet. So once you've done about a couple double crochets, you can now cut off the end of your yarn, but make sure it's the shorter end. And now you can continue on till you have about 45 through 50, and it helps if you count as you go. Thank you. So once you've finished, I'm now going to show you how to end it. So you're going to stick your hook through the first double crochet that you did, and make sure you stick it in the first two loops at the top. And you're just going to pick up a piece of yarn and pull it through the two loops, and then pull it through the loop that's on your hook. And then you're just gonna chain one and pull it through the loop just to secure it even more. And then you're going to cut off, but make sure you go a little ways just in case, because sometimes the yarn unravels. So you just wanna be sure, and then pull it really tight. And now we're just going to weave it in through the scrunchie. So if you have a needle, you can use that, but I'm just using my crochet hook. And I'm just gonna kind of find a spot in my scrunchie to weave it through so that it's not noticeable. And then I just worked my way down to the very center of my scrunchie, and then I just weaved it around until there was no yarn left. But if you have a little bit left, you can just cut it off, and then you're pretty much finished. Enjoyed learning how to make these cute little scrunchies. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.